The idea to use directed energy as a weapon is around since Archimedes. Since about 1890, the word death ray was used for what today is named directed energy weapons. Reports about weapons using various forms of directed energy were very frequent back then.
Let's for example have a look at publications in the United States magazine Modern Mechanics.
In May 1929, we find the report "Death Ray Stops Motors." The picture shows a device generating and projecting directed energy at a motorcycle to interfere with the ignition and thus stop the engine. A motorcycle is a relatively soft target because the ignition system is not covered by the sheet metal of the body like in a car. The wires of the ignition system can pick up radio frequency radiation easily, causing a variety of malfunctions. Which one will be the first to appear and cause the engine to stop depends on the exact circumstances. If sufficient energy of the right frequency is picked up by the wire leading to the spark plug, it will constantly fire. This video shows high frequency sparking at a radio frequency generator. The distance between the two conductors is about the same as in a spark plug. The total power of the generator was less than 40 watts at 175 MHz. The air-gas mixture already will ignite during the intake, the flame will pass to the carburetor and cause a fire, stopping the engine. A train of short pulses may cause early firing of the spark plug, which may damage the engine. Similar high-frequency sparking may also appear inside the ignition coil. In this case, the high-frequency sparks bridge the isolation and cause a short circuit of the high voltage produced by the coil. The spark plug does not fire and the engine stops.
In January 1933, the Modern Mechanics article, "Do Wild Radio Waves Cause Air Disasters?" explains the conditions under which radio waves cause dangerous effects. Thousands of volts may be induced in metallic structures like the frames of skyscrapers at some distance.
This is especially the case when the length of the metallic structure matches the frequency of the transmitter. In this case, the metal object is in resonance with the radio frequency radiation and becomes an effective antenna. However, if the transmitted power is high enough, even metallic objects with a length not matching the wavelength may cause damage. This was the case with the Swiss shortwave transmitter Schwarzenburg in 1939. The transmitter building had been built from wood using iron nails. The English technicians warned that this would cause trouble and got the answer that there is no scientific proof that shortwave of 20 MHz could cause nails to glow. So the technicians installed the transmitter. During several short tests of only a few minutes, nothing happened. On the first operational day, the station director, after 40 minutes, called his superiors and asked for permission to terminate the transmission or at least to reduce the power because the nails were glowing. Pointing to the fact that this was not scientifically possible, this was refused. Another 20 minutes later, the superiors received a call to send the fire brigade because the building was burning. This picture shows a large X-ray tube. X-radiation may also be used in a directed energy weapon, but as the range of X-rays in air is restricted to a couple of meters, it cannot be used at long distance. It also requires special optics, which are complicated and expensive. The original directed energy death ray was heat radiation. Here is a picture of a powerful infrared projector published in 1936. Even if this infrared projector was barely able to kill, the effect would be very similar to the modern active denial system. Another heat ray device was already described by Alexei Tolstoy in his novel Geheimnisvolle Strahlen, English, The Death Box. He wrote the book after having lived between 1921 and 1923 in Germany. My copy, printed in East Berlin in 1957, has this interesting drawing. The energy source described is a compressed charge of a thermite-like composition, producing a continuous heat ray. The heat ray is focused by a parabolic mirror. In the vicinity of the focal point, a second hyperbolic mirror is reflecting the directed energy through a hole in the parabolic mirror. The small mirror in the drawing is bent in the wrong direction, but if carefully constructed, the heat would be projected in a thin, high-power beam. This combination is called Cassegrain reflector and used in optical telescopes. It would allow to use any powerful heat source, including a wood stove, to project a heat ray over some short distance. The sun, with its parallel rays, would allow for a very long distance directed energy weapon. The exiting ray can be directed into any direction with a flat mirror. An amplitude modulation of such a heat ray, say with a twisting glass plate passing between angles of reflection and passage, should be able to produce sidebends and low frequency beats between these sidebends. Such low frequency beats induce electric currents in the body to affect the nerves. An effect only can be expected if the single waves of light are truly modulated in amplitude, not by simply dimming the light. A more portable directed energy gun was shown in the January 1935 issue of Modern Mechanics. This handy gun was reported to stun animals at a range of a mile. It was assumed that the heat used was generated by a thermite-like composition. Henri Claudel's directed energy weapon seems to be a laser-type death ray. There are various reports that lasers were known well before their invention in 1960. The theory was already published in 1916 by Albert Einstein. There are reports that since the 1930s, it was technically possible to build a laser. Even if this apparatus was not a real coherent laser, it could be a sort of crystal rod, possibly doped to produce a powerful light of a single frequency, if heated with a burner or electrically. Dr. Antonio Longoria is reported in February 1940 to having invented a death ray which also looks much like a powerful laser-style light generator. This article looks like a call to scientists to keep their research secret because of World War II, which just had started. Germany also was working on these techniques. Several United States Secret Service reports have been published about the use of such weapons against American aircraft in 1944. This German-directed energy weapon was interfering with the ignition of the engines, much like the first one in this video.